Hi there. Do you need a GIF? Perfect. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make a GIF from a video online. First, I'll show you how to make a GIF using Giphy. Then I'll show you how to get it done using Ezgif. They both have pros and cons, so this video is a good way for you to decide which one you'd rather use. First up, you'll need a video to turn into a GIF. Duh. Make sure it's under 60 seconds and less than 100 megabytes in size. Not millibytes, they don't exist. This will ensure that your video is the right size for most online GIF makers. Likewise, bear in mind that you need a great video to make a great GIF. I'll be using this video of a dancing sloth as my example. All right, this is Giphy, one of the most popular places to make and share GIFs on the internet. Chances are that your favorite cat meme was made by someone using Giphy. To start, hit create, then select choose video, sip on your coffee for a little while. Once your vid is uploaded, use the sliders to get the length of your GIF and the start point just right. In the next step, you can add some bling to your video like stickers, text, or filters. I'm only adding text, but it's worth experimenting with filters. Glitch and lightning are my favorites for adding some extra razzle dazzle. Finish by hitting upload to Giphy. And voila, there's your GIF. To save it to your computer, you have to be a bit sneaky, right-click and save the file. Now here's a pro tip for you. Giphy GIFs are public by default, and if you want to keep your GIF for yourself, sign up to Giphy first and set your channel to private. This is Ezgif. It's an alternative tool that you can use to turn your video into a GIF. Now, don't let the very basic interface fool you. This is a great tool that offers a lot more control than Giphy. To begin, choose your video file, then hit upload. Do a little waiting. Then hit convert to GIF. Now you can see your output, and most importantly, you can see how big your file is. Is it too big? No problem. Hit optimize and pick either lossy GIF compression or drop frames. Either works pretty well. Then hit optimize GIF. Now, reducing size does mean reducing quality, so you'll need to find a compromise that you're happy with. Click on save and your GIF will automatically download to your hard drive. There's a load of other settings in Ezgif that are really useful, like reversing your GIF, cropping it, and adding a watermarked logo. Now we've got the important stuff out of the way, let's address the elephant in the room. Is it GIF or is it GIF? The man who created the format, Steve Wilhite, says GIF. But most people will say it like they read it, GIF. Unless you're a designer or you're particularly nerdy, then it'll be GIF.
It's amazing what comes clean with GIF cream.
Anyway, your choice. Now I've shown you how to make a GIF using two tools, but which one should you use? Giphy is great because it's really simple, but you can't control the GIF file size. And why does size matter? Well, if you're planning to use your GIF for your business, like in emails or newsletters, it's important that your GIF isn't too big. Big GIFs take ages to download. Keep your GIFs between half a meg and a whole meg. So now you know two ways to make a GIF from a video. Drop the GIFs you make into the comment section and let's see what you've got. If you want more easy video tips like this one, subscribe to the Biteable YouTube channel and give this video a big thumbs up. There's a load of other settings in Ezgif that are really useful, like reversing your GIF.
What's wrong?